Custom validations in enterprise data management add custom business logic to enforce data rules on your applications, dimensions, node types, and hierarchy sets. Let's explore how to work with and create custom validations. In this Financials Cloud viewpoint, notice that these parents have numeric ranges defined. Ideally, all children should be within the parents' defined range, but currently this rule isn't enforced. In a request, you can see the existing validations at work in real time. Adding a new company provides a default name, which triggers an application-specific validation. The error message tells you that the company name is limited to 3 characters. However, I can enter a name that is out of range for its parent without triggering a warning or error. I'll submit the request. With no approval or commit policies in place, the request is validated and the new company is committed to the dimension immediately, even with the out-of-range numbering. You can view existing custom validations from the Reports page. You can filter the list by application, dimension, node type, and hierarchy set. Let's create a custom validation to enforce numeric ranges in the company hierarchy. To create, edit, or delete custom validations, you must be either a service administrator or a user with owner or metadata manager permissions at the application or dimension level. Because this rule applies to parent-child relationships, I'll create it at the hierarchy set level. On the Validations tab for the hierarchy set, click Create. Enter a name and optional description for the validation, then click Create. On the Definition tab, click Edit. Enter a message for users if the validation fails. For trigger actions, select one or more actions to trigger the validation. For trigger properties, select one or more properties that will trigger the validation to run if they are updated. Validations are run for every trigger action and trigger property you define. As a best practice, add the minimum number of trigger properties or actions that still enforce your business logic. For request state, select Committed to exclude nodes that have been removed or deleted in the request from validation. This is the default option. Select Visualized to validate nodes that have been removed or deleted in the request. Under Severity, you can customize the validation severity level for requests in the Submit, Approve, and Commit stages, as well as when validating a viewpoint and exporting a dimension. To add an expression for the validation, click the Edit Expression icon. In this example, the validation succeeds either when the node's parent has no defined range properties or when the node name is within the parent's defined range properties. I'll start by dragging operators to the return statement to create the structure of the expression. The first test checks if the parent node's range from and range to properties are blank. The second test uses the greater than or equal and less than or equal methods to check the node's name against its parent's range from and range to properties. You can test expressions against existing nodes in a viewpoint. When I test the expression against a node with a valid name, the evaluation comes back true. When I test the expression against the invalid node I added earlier, the evaluation comes back false. Click Apply to save the expression and return to the Definition tab. Enable and save the validation to start enforcing it. You can enable a validation only when it meets these conditions. A valid expression is defined, at least one trigger action or property is configured, and a failure message is defined. Now let's see what changes in the company viewpoint. In the viewpoint, you can run selected validations. The new validation flags the node I added earlier, as well as parent nodes under the EMEA parent. I'll correct these errors in a new request by renaming the invalid node and reorganizing the EMEA hierarchy. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.